在北大西洋窥探铁达尼号游轮残骸而宣告失联的观光潜水器找到了，但是映入眼帘的是船体的碎片。搜救团队星期四证实，潜水器发生灾难性内爆，失踪的五个人相信全部罹难。目前官方还无法鉴定潜水器在深海爆破解体的真正原因，而且要找到遇难者的遗体，机会非常渺茫。
就在各界聚焦潜水器的氧气存量逐步耗尽之际，加拿大一艘遥控声纳潜水器22号在铁达尼号沉船的船头488米处发现了失踪潜水器的部分残骸。参与搜救工作的深海专家在记者会上通报，遥控潜水器一共发现了5块主要残骸。由于现场环境极端恶劣，专家从寻获的碎片可以推测，失踪的潜水器当时发生了灾难性爆炸解体，不过目前还无法确定内爆的原因。接下来搜寻队伍将继续搜索有关区域，但是要寻获5名失踪者的遗体并不抱太大希望。
The initial thing we found was the nose cone, which was outside of the pressure hull.We then found a large debris field. Within that large debris field, we found the front end bell of the pressure hull. That was the first indication that there was a catastrophic event. Shortly thereafter, we found a second smaller debris field. Within that debris field, we found the other end of the pressure hull, the aft end bell, which was basically comprised of the totality of that pressure vessel.
美国海岸警卫队表示，早前侦测到的撞击噪音和寻获碎片的位置之间似乎没有任何关系，因为一般灾难性的船只爆破会在水下产生明显的宽带声音，声纳浮标会接收到相关讯号。有鉴于碎片现场与船只灾难性的内爆相符，官方已经通知失踪者家属告知罹难的噩耗。
The location of the Titan submersible was in an area that was approximately 1,600 feet from the wreck of the Titanic. The debris field is consistent with a catastrophic implosion of the vessel. Again, while we were prosecuting the search, we had listening devices in the water throughout and did not hear any signs of catastrophic failure.From those. And so we're going to continue to investigate, or we're going to continue to document the information there and understand, based on all the information we have, the timeline.
失踪家属等不到奇迹发生，只能悲痛接受亲人不幸罹难的事实。尽管如此，家属们还是衷心感谢搜救团队努力不懈的救援。五名探索百年沉船铁达尼号残骸之旅的遇难者分别是海洋之门探险公司执行长拉许、法国潜水器驾驶员纳尔乔莱、英国亿万富豪哈米什哈丁以及巴基斯坦富商达伍德和儿子苏勒曼。马新社电视综合报道。